Police officers make great sacrifices to keep our communities secure and safe. In 2018, our police arrested nearly 12,000 people for murder, 25,000 people for rape, and nearly 1.5 million for assault.
Joining us now to discuss the future of these reforms is Steve Rogers, a former police officer and FBI agent. He also serves as a member of the president's 2020 advisory board. So, Steve, when we look at the calls that are being made across the country, I mean, the defund the police movement spans differently depending on who you ask, anywhere from minor tweaks to the system that we have in place all the way to complete abolishment. Looking at what we've seen so far, do you agree with any of the reforms that have been proposed up to this point?
Look, the only reforms that I agree with are the president's reforms, because what he did was manage to create some reforms that will not hinder the police to do their duty, to do their job in protecting and to serve. I don't see a problem with a national database if you have a bad cop and that record has to follow him around or her around. But most of these reforms are going to simply create and I've described it this way, like at no other time in American history are we going to see the blood of crime victims flow in our streets, because the defunding of the police is simply a politically correct word of saying, let's get rid of the police. So we have some real serious thinking to do before we start moving on these so-called reform bills.
And we look at our elected leaders, too. A lot of those reform calls are being made by the Democratic leadership as well. I mean, some of them have gone from anywhere from saying that we should defund the police. Some go all the way to saying that we do need to abolish the police. Ilhan Omar was saying about the Minneapolis Police Department. AOC is saying the same thing. But then those on the right are saying that there are calls for some reforms to some degree. They're not going as far as their Democratic colleagues as well. But we don't think that there's necessarily the same type of support being shown from the for police on those on the right. Do you think that there should be more support from our Republican leaders?
Yes, that's a very good point you bring up. I am disturbed, as well as other law enforcement officers around the country, that, let me give you an example. There's a call for transparency, to release the records of police officers. You know, how many times were they charged with something? How many times were they involved in excessive force complaints? On and on and on. I was a police officer 38 years. I must have a million complaints against me. Even walking across a woman's lawn, that would be released to the public. So one of the things that I think we ought to do is also release all the good things they do. How many lives did they save? You know, what did they do with regard to catching burglars and armed felons? So indeed, there's not enough support from the Republicans, not enough of them speaking up. You need to get some guts. They need to have some courage and stand shoulder to shoulder with good cops, never with bad cops. I don't think any good cop would ever advocate that. But we need our leaders to stand up with us.
And I mean, even when the riots were going on a couple of weeks ago, they've since settled down. But I noticed in videos that, for example, people would be chanting against the police and then something would happen and the police would be the ones responding to that violent scene. People would be running behind the police. I mean, it goes to show you that people want to point the finger at police all the time, and it's very easy to do so until you need them. And I think that's something that people forget in times like this. So we do see, though, that some city officials are taking that extraordinary step of abolishing police departments, most notably Minneapolis. The city council voted that they are going to dismantle the police department. It's still unknown exactly what they're doing there. Do you fear that this could become a more national trend where other people start adopting those type of policies because we're not seeing that support for law enforcement?
It's going to become a national trend because of two reasons. One is that, as we just talked about, the politicians that are supposed to be standing up for liberty and justice are not doing that. And they always do it for political reasons. I mean, that's the end of the day. They want to appease the left, I guess, when they run for office. Maybe they think they're going to get some support. It'll never happen. But the other reason is that the police in this country right now are in a state of shock. The police academies, they're emptied out, if you will. Recruitment is at an all-time low. Retirements and resignations are at an all-time high. There may not be any police departments left to defund by the time this is over. So we've got some real serious problems down the road. And until our lawmakers are ready to stand up and do what's right, and what's right is to defend and support good cops. I want to emphasize that word, good. They do that, and we'll be better off.
No, I think that's very well said. And I'll say this once again to our viewers, too. Say thank you to a police officer. Buy them a pizza or something one of these days, because they're going through a very hard time right now themselves. And as you were saying, too, a very overwhelming majority of them are very good people who do excellent work. But Steve Rogers, I appreciate you coming on, breaking down this issue for us. Thank you. And coming up next, the Navy.